Life on Mars? Perseverance found organic molecules. It's one of our greatest cosmic misfortunes that we have completely missed the golden age of Mars. About 3.5 billion years ago, during the first billion years of the solar system's existence, the red planet was indeed a blue planet, flooded with oceans, seas, and rivers as Earth is today. But all was lost, even before the same great miracle began to take place on our planet. Ancient sedimentary basins, delta estuaries, and riverbeds are all that remain of Mars's watery past, which ended when the planet's magnetic field broke down, allowing the solar wind to drag away the atmosphere and water to be lost to space. Many things could have happened in that first billion years, including the emergence of life. On Earth, life began well before the planet's billionth birthday, leading many exobiologists-scientists studying the possibility of extraterrestrial life to believe that wherever there is liquid water and the correct chemistry, biology could quickly take hold. We believed it to such an extent that we've done nothing but send at least a dozen robotic machines between landers and rovers to the sands of the red planet over the past few decades, not counting those that didn't make it, just as many. Remotely controlled explorers, stationary or self-propelled chemical laboratories, all employed to provide an answer to the question that most torments our anxiety as creatures who feel alone in a universe that at the moment seems to be made of matter alone. And now it's news recently, after years of faint signs and only partial clues, it seems that our faith in a concept of life extended to all planetary environments may be rewarded by a discovery made by the latest robotic explorer to land on Mars. The Perseverance rover, in fact, reached an area of high geological interest this summer, and initial analysis of the sedimentary rocks it collected confirm a wet past and the presence of a high concentration of organic molecules, compatible with the development of life forms. Let's try to figure out together if this is something really important. But first, let's take stock of the scenario that led to this situation, shall we? Perseverance is a car-sized Mars rover designed to explore the Jezero crater on Mars. It was manufactured by the Jet Propulsion Laboratory and launched on July 30, 2020. Confirmation that the rover successfully landed on Mars was received on February 18, 2021. Perseverance has a similar design to its predecessor rover, Curiosity, although it was moderately upgraded. It carries 7 primary payload instruments, 19 cameras, and 2 microphones. They also differ in important mission-specific ways. While Curiosity was identified and continues to study environments where ancient microbes could have lived, Perseverance will seek direct signs of ancient life and prepare geological samples that a future mission could bring back to Earth. The rover also carried the mini-helicopter Ingenuity to Mars, an experimental aircraft that made the first powered flight on another planet on April 19, 2021. The Perseverance rover has 4 main science objectives that support the Mars Exploration Program's science goals. Looking for habitability, identify past environments that were capable of supporting microbial life. Seeking biosignatures, seeking signs of possible past microbial life in those habitable environments, particularly in specific rock types known to preserve signs over time. Caching samples, collect core rock and regolith, soil samples, and store them on the Martian surface. Preparing for humans, test oxygen production from the Martian atmosphere. Perseverance destination, the Jezero crater, was announced by NASA back in November of 2018, and the site was chosen for more than 60 possible candidates, which makes one realize how extraordinary its characteristics must be. The explanation for so much consideration lies in the fact that Jezero represents, from a geological and biological point of view, a real gold mine. In its more than 45 kilometers of extension, the crater is in fact home to an ancient delta formed 3.5 billion years ago at the convergence of a Martian river and a lake. To realize this, only one has to look at a satellite photo of it. Even at a first glance, one can recognize rock formations that can be traced to the delta-like mouths of three rivers, two tributaries, and one outflow. The sedimentary bed that makes up the delta was deposited in very remote ages, when water flowed over the Martian surface, and the river flowed into the crater forming a lake. The waters flowed into a lake carry fine material that, as the estuary opens and the velocity decreases, is deposited in large quantities, forming stratifications. It is precisely this peculiarity that may have preserved any organic material intact at depth. If life was present on Mars at the time, then some trace may have remained preserved within the rocky layers, protected from the atmospheric changes that slowly transformed the planet into its present state. After spending its first year traversing the bottom of the ancient lake, however, finding not sedimentary rock but compact igneous rock, probably formed by the fall of the asteroid that excavated the crater, in April 2022, Perseverance finally arrived in the Delta region, where the second phase of its mission began. Perseverance's mission to search for biomarkers on the Martian surface is in fact divided into several campaigns named after each area of interest. The Crater Floor Campaign, which began soon after arrival on the Red Planet in February of 2021, engaged the rover on the crater floor in search of the best rocks to sample. Heading initially south from its landing point, Perseverance then reached the sand dunes of Sedia from the east, then ascended north, and finally took a westward direction to reach the river delta. And it was in that chaotic and very interesting region last July, as NASA reports, that the rover collected the long-cherished evidence. In fact, Perseverance took some samples from a rock formation called Wildcat Ridge, probably formed when water slowly began to evaporate and mud and fine sand began to settle. A couple of samples were taken from a rock outcrop known as Skinner Ridge, which is made of fine-grained sandstone, similar to a type of rock seen in many places on Earth. Seen up close in the sampling tubes where Perseverance is storing the finds, the Skinner Ridge cores appear light-colored and studded with round grains of dark material. These darker grains were probably transported by the ancient river that once flowed to Jezero from regions perhaps hundreds of kilometers away. Thus, the study of the grains could tell scientists the story of distant areas of Mars. The other pair of samples comes from a spot called Wildcat Ridge, a sedimentary rock about a meter wide that is only 20 meters from Skinner Ridge. These samples are lighter in color, more homogeneous, and finer grained than the cores of Skinner Ridge. And Earth's geology teaches that the finer the grains of a rock, the more likely it is to contain evidence of past life. In fact, on Earth, small grains tend to settle in low-energy environments such as the bottom of a pond, where they can preserve decaying organisms or other signs of life settling there. On July 20th, the rover set out to analyze the collected material with a sophisticated scientific instrument called Scanning Habitable Environments with Raman and Luminescence for Organics and Chemicals, or SHERLOCK. And to everyone's surprise, Wildcat Ridge turned out to be the richest sample of organics ever found on Mars so far. Hang on a sec, guys, before we continue. Be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell. You will help us to make products of even higher quality. Okay, but why is this so important? And what exactly is organic matter? Organic molecules are made up of a wide variety of compounds, consisting mainly of carbon and usually also include hydrogen and oxygen atoms. In addition, they may contain other elements such as nitrogen, phosphorus, and sulfur. Although they may also be produced by chemical processes that have nothing to do with biology, some of these compounds are considered to be true biosignatures, that is evidence that billions and billions of microorganisms once swarmed in the waters of Lake Jezero, eventually ending their lives encompassed in the bottom sediments. In practice, the most optimistic hypothesis is that in the distant past, the sand, mud, and salts that now make up the Wildcat Ridge rock were deposited in an environment that could potentially have supported life. And the fact that organic matter was found in a sedimentary rock, a type that on Earth is synonymous with the fossilization of ancient biological forms, is obviously very important. Does this mean that Perseverance has found evidence of life on Mars? The answer is no, we cannot be sure. As effective as the instruments aboard Perseverance are, coming to further conclusions about the contents of the Wildcat Ridge sample, we'll have to wait until they're returned to Earth for a more in-depth study. Although as of now, there is at least the certainty that the river delta within Jezero crater contains exactly the type of sedimentary rock for which Perseverance was built and sent to this area of Mars. For this reason, the rover is equipped with 43 titanium tubes, in which it caches the Martian soil and rock it is studying. So far, a dozen test tubes have been filled and sealed, and all will eventually be deposited in a well-marked spot on the Martian surface. The project plans to collect at least 20 samples to bring back to Earth in the future, although the researchers hope to be able to fill all 43 tubes. Having collected the samples, the researchers will also have to decide where to have Perseverance leave them on the Martian soil. It is not yet clear whether they will have the cargo deposited in one place, or whether they will decide to create at least two separate deposits so that they will have backup samples in case something goes wrong. The tubes are expected to ensure the integrity of the samples for at least 20 years on Mars, a congruous amount of time for the development of the recovery mission, about which there are still many questions to be answered. In 2028, NASA and the European Space Agency will launch a Mars sample return mission, which should bring a new rover to Mars to retrieve the samples and load them into a mini rocket, which should then take them into orbit around Mars. At this point, a probe should intercept the container with the tubes and bring it back to Earth. Nothing like this has ever been attempted, but having those samples on our planet would allow for much deeper and more precise analysis in search of clues to Martian life. That's the good news. The not-so-good news, or at least the less immediately gratifying, is that it will be a long time before scientists can learn whether the ingredients of Martian biology actually signify the long-ago, or even existing, presence of Martian biology. In fact, samples are not expected to be delivered to Earth until 2033 at the earliest. And this also means that the long-awaited first human landing on the Red Planet will not take place before that date. In the meantime, the scenario of the return of the samples is our best bet to find out whether our once watery planetary neighbor was also a living neighbor. The just-announced Perseverance discovery raises the possibility, at least a little, that the answer to the question may be yes.